I'm just glad that Eva Marie is suspended, so she won't be in this match.
Thank God.
Because you know that if she was going to be in this match, she probably would have won.
Yeah. And she probably would have won she probably would have, like, walked down to the ring. And, like, someone would have been knocked down the ring and she just would have pinned and walked out.
Yep.
But they need someone like Becky to take it. Because they need someone like that. Don't give it to Nikki, because she literally just...
She just had came it. Back.
Yeah.
And she just...
Put her in a feud with Carmella and then have Becky with it with Alexa Bliss and let them feud for it.
Which she just came back after having, at the time, you know, that she had the longest Divas Championship reign. And then on top of that, they try to do a double turn with Nikki trying to turn face, Carmella turning heel. I didn't see it like that. Because when Nikki won that match at SummerSlam, she gave the big L, you know, the loser, to Carmella and treated her like shit. So why are people booing Carmella because she's attacking Nikki?
Right?
Doesn't make any sense. Carmella is the babyface in this to me. I'm not going to boo her.
Yeah, I'm not going to boo Carmella. Fuck Nikki.
Right? I mean, Carmella was just getting back at her. Everybody wants to boo her for some reason. Like I said, wrestling's weird.
Yeah.
There's just some things that you just gotta
accept that it doesn't fucking make sense sometimes.
We know that SummerSlam didn't make a whole lot of sense, but I know something that does make sense, and that's AJ Styles going against Dean Ambrose for the WWE Championship after coming off one of the biggest wins of his career I've seen so far, off John Cena clean SummerSlam. He's going on to the WWE Championship match, which I like that he went against Dolph Ziggler. And AJ won,
Brian did not clarify that very well, because I didn't know if it was, because they said that it was AJ Styles, like, you know, because he said if Styles wins, he gets a championship, but if Ziggler wins, he's added to the match. I'm like, wait a minute, what?
Yeah, I thought, you know, okay, regardless of what happens here, AJ Styles is going into the WWE Championship.
Yeah.
But yeah, they didn't really clarify, and then the announcers later on, they said, number one contenders match, who will face Dean Ambrose? Like, wait, what?
Yeah.
WTF!
WTF, yeah. But that fucking match between Ziggler and Styles, holy shit, dude.
It was great.
It was fucking, SmackDown is the place to fucking be, dude.
I mean, Raw's gonna have to step it up, because, like, I'm getting kind of tired of sitting there for 3 hours to be really disappointed.
Right, at this point, I'm just kind of waiting for fucking the Cruiserweight division to hit Raw.
Yep, September 19th. The Cruiserweight to come into Raw. Can't wait to see who's gonna be in it. I heard Cedric Alexander's supposed to be in it. I heard, what is this dude's name? Kata Ibushi?
Yeah.
Yeah, Ibushi's supposed to be in it. I think they're gonna get Ho Ho Lun in there. Neville's definitely gonna be one of the faces, if not should be the face of the Cruiserweight division.
Kalisto should be there, but they put him in SmackDown.
So they got Botch Cara.
Yeah.
So they got Sin Cara there.
Actually, this Sin Cara is not the Botch one.
Yeah, you know. I don't know, man. I can't wait for the Cruiserweights to come back. Maybe that'll make Raw watchable.
Yeah, well,
maybe something
for that part of it.
Yeah, just for that part. Kind of like, you know, when WCW, they used to have the Cruiserweights on for the first hour of the show.
Yeah.
What if they did something like that for the Cruiserweights?
It'd be fucking, they deserve it, dude. Cruiserweights are awesome.
Now, I don't know if they should have the first hour of Raw. I would think definitely the second hour.
Yeah, because the middle part's usually, it's always like, oh my god.
That's just like a low point of the show. The beginning is great. First hour is great. The second is kind of, you know, okay. And then the third hour is where it's like, oh. Because you've been sitting there for so fucking long, just like, please, something interesting happen.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, SmackDown has won this war so far.
Yeah.
SmackDown's taking it.
Yeah, we got a potential feud with Orton Wyatt, which I think is gonna be good.
I'm down.
God, I'm sorry, Orton. I know you just came back and you got beat up by Lesnar. Give Bray the win. God, he...
Especially since he's by himself now.
He needs a win. And he needs consequences to his wins and losses. That's the biggest problem I have with Wyatt. Is it... I'm a god. I'm like, okay, but you're a god who doesn't... None of your shit matters.
Which is kind of what happened.
One brings it up, too. I want someone to be like, okay, you talk about being a god, but you're... What have you done, really?
Right, it's kind of like what happened when Eric Rowan lost his match against Dean Ambrose. Was it, like, last week on SmackDown? And Wyatt, you know, he turned his back on him and left the sheet mask in the rocking chair. That's a consequence. I like that. So let's see, you know, that play into it. You know, like, you know, Randy can bring it. Like you said, you know, you say you're a god, but what have you done to earn that title or to deserve that?
You know, and Orton's really, one of those kind of shit talkers who would bring up something like that.
Yeah. Well, it only takes one RKO to go to Viperville. But it only takes about 7 losses to follow the buzzards. I don't know.
Right.
Yo. Let's talk about the Intercontinental Champion.
Yes.
All the titles were held in the highest regards on SmackDown. They were showing off lovely, except for one, and that was the Intercontinental Championship.
Yes.
Justin, you are the bigger fan of The Miz than I can only say, you know, a few things about it, but since you love The Miz,
yes I do,
you take this one.
Alright, for those who don't know, usually after SmackDown they have a show called Talking Smack, which is hosted by Daniel Bryan and Renee Young, and The Miz was on there, and The Miz was talking about how, you know, I'm the Intercontinental Champion, you know, you need to start treating me with more respect and stuff like that. Which, basically, they went kind of back and forth, and Brian was talking about... He basically straight up said that Miz wrestles like a coward, you know.
Right, like he wrestles the WWE soft style. You know?
Which, The Miz, and, like, it was... This promo was so good, you could have sworn it was a fucking shoe.
Right? Just the passion that was coming out of him.
Which Miz basically brought up the fact, you know, he's like... You know, I've been here for 10 years and never been hurt one time. You don't want to know why I wrestle the same style I do? It's because, you know, I've been here. I've never been hurt, you know. You want to call me... Yeah,
I don't get hurt.
You want to call me a coward? What about the... You know, and he started talking about Brian, about how he kept promising the fans to be back. You know, it's like, just you love wrestling so much, you want to be in that WWE ring, then why don't you quit? Why don't you go to the bingo halls with your indie buddies if you love wrestling so much? But you call me the coward? Instead of just sitting there taking an authority position, which...
That's it. That's what I was going to tell you. I was watching PWF Empire, and J-Dub brought it up, saying that now Daniel Bryan is in an authority-type role, and he's basically telling Miz that he doesn't have what it takes. He doesn't have what it takes. He can't cut it, he doesn't live up to what Daniel Bryan expects of him, just like the authority used to say to Daniel Bryan.
Exactly.
So now he's flipping that around to The Miz, and now I see, once I brought that up after I saw the promo, like, holy shit, that makes a whole lot of sense. Why is Daniel Bryan doing this to The Miz? Maybe is he trying to light the fire under him to try to, you know, bring something out of him?
Then The Miz, dude, it looked like The Miz, he was so passionate in his promo that he was about to cry, which is amazing.
He was about to cry. It's the best promo I've seen since the pipe bomb.
Yes, and then Miz was talking about, I'm tired, you know, which was even amazing because Miz is like, I'm the one who loves the fans. I'm the one who loves everything. I'm the one who's here every day. You know, and I am sick and tired of people like, of other people and people like you talking down to me like this.
But wait, this show is...
Yeah, and
Renee
Young,
about
the show called Talking Smack, you know... She's like, you know, and when Miz is, you know, talking smack to Brian, she's like, this is not what this show's about. I'm like, what the fuck, Renee?
It's called Talking Smack. Like, that's what, the name of the show is Talking Smack. That's what he's doing. He's talking smack. But he's talking real smack.
You know. And it was cool because he was like, you know, turn the cameraman at me, and he was throwing his shit, and the way he stormed off, and the way Brian stormed off too.
They just added that sense of realism. Like, is that a shoot?
So
is that a work?
Good, dude. The Miz is incredibly underrated.
If you're not a fan of The Miz before, you'll definitely
I'm telling you,
have
they have it. They have
afterwards.
The clip on their YouTube. Just go watch it if you have not seen it yet. Yeah,
go
it
out
is
of your way.
Fucking worth it to see the kind of passion that The Miz brought in that.
Yeah, trust me, just go out of your way. It's only a few minutes. You have to see this. The passion that he brings, the drive, desire, the, you know, he's believing everything he says and everything he's saying.
Yeah,
he's got
he
a
does.
Good point. It's the best promo I have seen since the pipe bomb. And I saw that post on Facebook, which is true. It probably is the best one. Because, like, we've never seen Miz bring that kind of emotion to a promo like that before. Really, any kind of emotion? Oh, I haven't. I don't know about you, Justin, but I
nothing
haven't.
Nothing like that.
I've never been the biggest fan of The Miz. I've told you this before. But after that promo, it's like, and even, you know, the past couple of months as him being Intercontinental Champion, I've converted over to him. But that promo, it showed me a side of him that I've never seen before. And he brought up all those good points and all the passion, all the drive he had. I respect him. I respect the man. Man, he has earned every bit of respect that I have. And like you said, he's definitely underrated. And I see bigger and brighter
right.
things
he's
for
the Miz.
He's
held
the
Intercontinental
in the
Championship for 140 plus days. When's the last time anyone's held the Intercontinental Championship more than fucking a month?
Right? The IC title's become like the hot potato belt, like the WWF
right.
title back in the day. It's like a hot potato. We get behind someone, and then they just kind of cut them off, and then the next guy wins. And then it's just rinse, repeat. That's kind of like what they did with the U.S. title
yeah.
there for a bit. And Rusev held the U.S. title for a long time, too. He's criminally underrated.
Yeah, definitely.
Both champions, man. These guys can carry this mid-card. And Miz, he could be WWE champion again one
I
day.
I believe so.
Now that the title's on SmackDown and is being shown more prominently, I think Miz could definitely be WWE champion again. And like you said, he's like the only true heel in the company. So just imagine, you know, him going against, you know, Dean Ambrose, AJ Styles, you know, guys like that.
Exactly.
Because Miz can go.
Yeah,
Miz
he does.
Go.
He's super aggressive in the ring, too, and he can fucking... Miz rarely puts on a bad match.
Mm-hmm. He uses psychology. He's a smart wrestler. I've seen that.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see what happens with really all of SmackDown, man.
Oh,
I am
yeah,
so
dude.
Into SmackDown.
Blue is the way to go.
SmackDown is the place. SmackDown's the place to be.
Well, man, that is all we got. We are out of topics.
Is there anything else that we can mention at all?
Not off the top of my head.
The new, the WWE, the 2K17.
Nope,
I've seen gameplay of that.
2K17.
It looks
not at all.
You don't care? I've seen it. It looks okay. I'm still not going to get it.
I bet it's
going to
be slow
play
and janky
games.
Like the last couple ones have.
Right? The last good WWE
yeah.
game was 14. That one was fantastic. Ever since then, it's copy paste,
copy and
paste,
down.
Copy paste. Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
But this is a great day and age to be a wrestling fan. I'm going to say that, and then... That's it. That's all I got. All
right, well, thank you all for joining this session of Relax Play, a.k.a. Trey's Point of View, a.k.a. Wrestling Talk. Yeah.
A.k.a. Trigger Play.
If you like this video and all our videos, please remember to, you know, drop that thumbs up, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, check us all out on all of our media platforms. And we will see you all, guys, in the next Relax Play. Bye.
Yeah, buddy. Yep.
Bird.